guys, it's HoppingHammy, and today I'm going to be doing the photography tag, which has 10 questions relating to photography. And this is actually something that SparkleGirl00 did on her channel, and I thought it sounded like fun, so I was like, do you mind if I do it too? So I'm going to be answering 10 questions, and if this is not anything that interests you, that's okay, but I am going to be doing this video for the people who are interested. So we'll go ahead and get started. My voice is a little bit raspy today for some reason, so. Okay, so the first question that we have is, how did you get into photography? I just wanted to start taking pictures. I don't really know why, but my dad had this old camera from work and he brought it home and he was like, we don't use this anymore, so you can play around with it. So I did, and I had a dog and I wanted to take photos of her. So I just started experimenting, and of course the camera was really horrible quality and everything, but as I got into it more, I upgraded and I wanted to get an official DSLR camera, so that pretty much started my quest into photography, I guess. Number two, what camera do you use? So currently I use the Canon 60D, and I've had this camera for a couple of years. I mostly got it for the filming capabilities because it has a screen that flips out so I can see what I'm doing. So that makes life a little bit easier, but I probably will upgrade the camera body at some point in future, but for now it's wonderful and it does everything I need it to do, so I'm very, very happy with it. Number three, studio light or natural? I probably prefer natural just because it has a certain quality about it that can't really be reproduced with studio lights. I don't think so anyway, but I also like studio lights and they do have their place. For example, they're handy when I'm filming and it's like nighttime and I, you know, don't have any lighting or anything like that. They're also great because you can customize exactly how you want to set up your lighting, and sometimes the sun won't always cooperate with you. You know, it might be like somewhere different that you don't want it to be. So if you use like flash or studio lights or something like that, you can make it exactly how you want it to be if you have the knowledge on how to do that. Now, I don't. Lighting is something I've always sort of struggled with, but I like them both in their own way. So number four, which photography style do you like best? So my personal style is probably like a mix of vintage and soft pastels and creamy bokeh and stuff like that. I really enjoy doing. I also like doing self-portraits. Now, these are not selfies. I want to make this clear. There's a huge difference between selfies and self-portraits. Self-portraits have a certain artistic element to them that selfies, obviously, if you're just like, you know, duck lips, that's like my big pet peeve, but self-portraits are more like, I said, they're like artistic, I guess. And it focuses more on the photography rather than on the person. Do you edit your pictures? I do edit my pictures, and it depends on what I'm shooting, but if I'm doing something like scenic, I generally don't do a lot of editing. I like to just do a little bit of contrast and maybe some dodging and burning, which basically enhances the shadows and the highlights and stuff like that. So I don't typically do a lot of editing for those types of photos, but for other types of photos where perhaps my lighting wasn't, you know, 100% perfect or anything like that, I might do a little bit more. I might add some Photoshop actions or some toning for colors and stuff like that. I find that really fun. That's actually my favorite part about photography, is the editing afterwards. So yeah. What is your favorite lens? So this one's a little bit difficult because it really just depends on what I'm shooting. So like for hamster stuff, I typically use my Tamron 28-75mm, and that's like a perfect range. But if I'm doing portraits, I really like the 85 1.8, and this lens is so gorgeous. It is just so, like, the quality is so smooth and creamy, and it's very quiet when you use it as well. It just, you can tell when you feel it that it's a very well-made lens. So that one's probably my favorite lens out of all of my collection. Number seven, do you plan out photo shoots? It's kind of embarrassing how many photo shoots I actually have planned out for future, and I most likely will never get around to all of them, but the one that I'm working on currently, which I've talked about a lot, is the Ice Queen photo shoot, and I'm really hoping to have it done by January so I can post it on YouTube. And then after that, I have another one that's already planned out. So yes, I do typically plan very far in ahead different ideas that I have that I want to put into photos. Number eight, what is the picture you are most proud of? I really can't think of one right now that's like the number one photo I'm most proud of. If I think of it, I'll put it on the screen, but like most of the photos that I'm most proud of were just a completely lucky shot. Like it was nothing to do with talent or anything. It was just everything happened to come together perfectly for the photo, the lighting, the composition, you know. So those are typically the photos that I really like the most. Okay, we're almost done here. So, number 9, what is the last picture you took? Well, like I said, I'm working on the Ice Queen project, so I took a photo for that a couple days ago. I was actually battling a fiery dragon in the land of Silvervale. So, this one I have to do some compositing to add some elements that weren't in the photo because I just don't have unlimited funds to buy stuff. So. But that was the last photo that I did, and I'm so excited to show that project. Why do you take pictures? Pictures and photography for me is something that I find relaxing to do. If I'm ever stressed out, I love to just grab my camera and go outside and photograph leaves or bugs or just stuff like that. And I'm a very creative person, so it's one of those things that I find is perfect for me to be able to put my creativity into photo. So. I hope you guys enjoyed listening to these 10 questions, and thank you for supporting my channel. I'm going to have another cage tour, a room tour, and a package trade video for the rest of this month. I don't know if I'll have time to do anything else. I'm honestly so busy this month, but thank you for watching, and take care. I'll see you in the next video. Bye!